Hi guys, welcome to my channel. This is Mantram Shetty and today we have the father of SUVs, class, mafia, everything, the Range Rover Vogue Chess E. This car is powered with a V8 engine and we also have the owner of this car, Hussein, with us. He would give a complete ownership review of this car. So when did you get this car and what's the complete story behind it? And also I can see a custom interior and a custom paint on this car. So tell a complete story about it.
So I got this car in the mid-COVID times and early 2021. I got this car in original shade of black. I didn't know it was a wrap, okay? I went to a service station and when I opened the door, I realized that the jams are not black, it's silver. So then I'm like, okay, the car is wrapped. When I had a look, it turned out the car was wrapped by Motormine. Now, I did some research behind this car. Turns out, this car has a very big history. It started out in Haryana. It was HR16N. So it was in Haryana first. Then it went to Punjab. The second owner was in Punjab. Then the third owner went to Delhi. So the car's history ended in Delhi for some time. Then and it went to BBT, Big Boy Toys, to one of my friends, okay? And after some time, I bought it from him. Now, I bought it through a broker. I did not know it was his car. He then revealed to me that it is his car that I indirectly bought. Now, when I bought this car, I got a very good deal on it. But the thing was, the paint job below this wrap was not really good. So I was always annoyed with it. To cover it up, I removed the old wrap and I again wrapped the car in satin black. After I wrapped the car in satin black,
before this car was satin black.
So the car's first color was silver.
Yeah.
Then it went to normal black, plain black.
Yeah.
Then it went to satin black.
Okay.
Now this is the fourth iteration of the car.
Okay.
So this color spec is called Verde Hydra. As you can see, this is a Lamborghini color. This is a one of one spec in India. To come in a Lamborghini color, there are many British Racing Green Range Rovers in India. But very few of them are in this exact color scheme. Along with it, the interior is courtesy of Refurb Studio, who are situated in Bangalore. The interior is a complete Indian job. The interior is a inspired color. I wanted the interiors to be like a Mansory car. So I did all the carbon fiber treatment and changed the color of the seats to orange. I would say the car looks fantastic when you're rolling, etc. Another thing about the car that's very unique is when you open both the doors, there's a Range Rover symbol over here.
Oh, okay.
So this comes with only the Vogues. The thing that differentiates the Vogues between the normal sport and Vogue is meant for the people who want to sit in the back and enjoy.
Yeah.
Like basically an S-Class. That's why people...
Chauffeur-driven
cars. So you can even see the side steps I've added. When my friend bought the car, it was just a normal plate that used to come out. Now this is becoming to a side closing step, like I've demonstrated here. Yeah. The reliability stands. The car is unreliable. When I got the car, I did the first pull on the car. Those days the car was fine, not an issue. After 4 or 5 months of having the car, the car started releasing grey or white fumes, like clouds clouds of white fume. Like those RX-100 if you have seen all those,
smoke will be coming out.
Yeah. But then I did not want my car to do all of that. It's a Range Rover, it should not be doing all of this. I had a look from a very reputed garage in Bangalore, Mark 1 garage.
Okay.
When they had a look, it turns out the cylinder walls were worn out and the piston rings were cracking. So, basically it meant I had to rebuild the whole engine.
Okay.
So, I rebuilt the whole engine at 86,000 kilometers. I am from that 86,000 kilometers, I drove around 10,000 kilometers. Right now it's standing at 96. I bought the car when it was 80,000 kilometers driven. Now, speaking about the engine, the latch for these Range Rovers comes here.
Yeah, on the left side.
So, you have to open from here.
So actually, I have to say that the interior quality and the paint quality on this car is really beautiful, especially the interiors. I really love the color of which there on the interior and also the quality of work. Even those carbon fiber finish, everything just looks perfect.
So this is the heart of the engine. She's on her second life.
Okay.
This is a 4.4 liter twin scroll turbo V8,
okay,
which is producing around 640 horsepower and 700 newton meters of torque. And 700 newton meters of torque at 3000 RPM.
Oh.
This car is just mad. Like, you go on the highway, just rip it. You're just gonna see minimum speeds of 200.
Crazy.
This car is crazy when you're in, you know, a good condition where you can stretch the car's legs. Now the thing about this car is too massive. Now,
yeah,
if you try to, you know, hit somewhere, you have to be very mindful of how you're driving when you're driving this car. It's basically meant to be driven by a chauffeur. But when you're behind the wheel, you don't feel one thing about this car. It's like a very smooth and pleasant driving experience. And paired with the diesel engine, people say diesel is a bad thing about this car, but then I would say it's a good thing that, you know, Land Rover gave a diesel model for this car, because first of all, mileage of this car is not really that good. You get an average of around 6 to 4 on harsh driving conditions, and when you're sedately driving on the highways, you're getting around 10 to 12. So it's like pretty average driving, average fuel economy. Paired with petrol, it would have been a disaster to maintain. But thanks to diesel, I would say it is very, you know, self-reliable, easy for me to maintain this car and drive it on a daily basis. This has been really driven by my dad for last 3 years.
Oh.
I have another car, that's my S4.
We'll get a review on it really soon. Yeah.
I don't really daily drive it that much because it's too low. Like.
So another thing which I have to tell, that this car's road presence is really wonderful. So you guys can see the look of this car. It really stands out in the road, especially with this color. It looks really wonderful. And you guys can see even in the brake calipers are finished in orange so that it gets contrast with the interiors. You guys can see this car just looks too good, and this car is too huge. It's really a huge car. You guys can see at the rear, it's completely debadged, and it has got this mafia look from the back too. So now I'm in the rear seats of the Range Rover, and I really have to say the seats are really comfortable, and especially with these colors, it's like a big delight sitting here. And how's the experience with you and your family in these seats?
I'm pretty comfortable. Sometimes whenever I'm tired, I'll ask my mom and dad to sit in the front. My dad will be driving, I'll be sleeping in the back. This is how comfortable this car is. And usually I'm the one driving, so I'll ask my mom to sit back, and she's always very happy with this car. Her pet name for this car is Raja Gadi.
Okay.
That's just how much she loves this car. The car has features like, you know, cool seats over here, along with automatic 4-zone climate for all four seats. Like, this part is also controlled by, you know, a specific...
Separately controlled. Every single seat can be separately controlled. And rear seats have also got the ventilated function.
Ventilated function.
Yeah.
The front seats have massage function and cooling function. There is around both Meridian sound systems. Meridian sound systems are not very unheard of. But the thing is, Meridian sound systems are way more, you know, posh and better compared to Bose, and that's just what I've heard and experienced.
Yeah.
The vibe you get listening to these speakers is just on another level. Along with it, the car is just beautiful. There's a panoramic sunroof over here, which I have to start the engine up.
We'll show it when we go up to front.
The whole thing comes like this. Is also painted in black. Before it was beige in color.
Okay.
Now it has also been painted in black. There are special treatments done over here. This is the light. The car is off. That's why none of the features are working. Along with it, the car is just beautiful to look at from the interior sometimes.
Yeah.
You just sit in one corner and just look at the car, it's just beautiful. Apart, sometimes, you know, I feel the need, you know, you sit in the back, and when you get down, you feel like a mafia.
Yeah,
like, you know,
true.
People are just staring at you, like, who is this guy, from where did he come down?
You really get a mafia feel in this car, because this just looks badass from the outside, and the interior too is really wonderful.
This is driven by most, this car is driven by most of the CMs, most of ex-CMs and present CMs. It is also driven by our Mr. Honorable Prime Minister of India, Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And this is a car, even apna Mukesh Ambani's son enjoys driving sometimes. The seats for the chauffeur can be controlled from here. There's a switch, dedicated switch over here can be used to push
the seat ahead.
If you know there's no one sitting there and your chauffeur is driving the car,
you can extend your leg room.
And when you extend the leg room, the car is just, you can sleep in this car, honestly.
You
the seats are electronically managed.
You guys can see the controls here. You can just electronically adjust the things.
And we have the door lock and unlock function on the door card, which is not a common feature. The door handles are placed in a way that you can easily put your hand in and conveniently open the door. Apart, the bottle holders are massive. You can fit in at least like 2-3 liters of big one of those Bisleri bottles. You can just put it there and it will be fine. And there's a lot of space in this car, a lot of space. It's very airy, even for a tall person. My uncle is around 6'5". He's also comfortable sitting over here.
The seat is really comfortable, and also for even, it doesn't matter about your height, this car is so perfect.
True.
So now we are in the interior of the Range Rover. So now you guys can see the mirrors are turning back. Now let's start the car.
The steering wheel automatically comes down based on your driving position. So one is these are memory seats, which are a common feature for all luxury cars. So the thing about this car that's fascinating is that the car is just quirky in all its ways. There is you can see all your important features over here on the multi information display.
Is the multi information display stock or is it changed?
It's stock.
Okay.
So in 2013 it came with even in 2013 it came with virtual displays.
Okay.
And it has a torchlight effect. So when I arrived the car, you can see the RPMs just shifting from 5,000. Just how it's shifting. This is the torchlight effect that comes in this display. Along with it, I changed this and this. And all these steering mounted controls.
Okay.
And I did all the carbon fiber finish over here. This is real carbon fiber. This is not dip. This is not a dip version.
This is not a hydro dip, but a real carbon fiber.
It is layered on top of the it had wood finish on it before.
Okay.
But then I was not a fan of the wood finish and I wanted something more carbon fiber, more sporty.
Yeah.
So I changed it all to carbon
fiber. So actually it's complementing the color.
It's complementing the color a lot. And another thing about this car is that it has this paddle shifters.
Okay.
And the whole center console had to be removed to be changed. Everything is just changed over here. And another thing about the whole interior, when we were doing this interior work, the whole thing had to come apart. So when I went to see the car once in between, I saw nothing over here. I'm not even joking. I saw nothing over here because everything was being worked on. Even the steering wheel, even the trim panels, even the
dashboard.
Even this was repainted.
Okay.
Nothing was left. So even I changed the roof.
The roof was
cloth before. I did not like the finish of the cloth. That's why I changed it to leather. So when I finished rebuilding the engine, the cooling system of the car completely disintegrated, I would say. The pipes and all started leaking, it started bursting because there was a lot of new pressure that was building up after a long period of time. The engine was not running properly. So after the engine was proper, the cooling system was gone. So I went to Dubai. A lot of the car's part, even this was bought from Dubai, many things from this car was got from Dubai, okay? This
is also how did you get it here?
You put it in the luggage and you get it.
Okay, like
there was no issue.
See, if you get it for personal use, like you say, one or two small pipes and all, you take income, they won't ask you anything. But like if you get a lot of parts, they'll ask you, what are you doing with so many parts?
Mm-hmm.
If it's gonna go for your personal use, they won't tell anything, they'll just leave you. But if you say you're going for your own company's work, they're just gonna put a imposition duty,
custom duty,
and leave you. Carrying car parts is not a crime. I have even taken wheels, 20 inch rims from London to Bangalore.
Okay.
That's just how much method I've done for one of my cars. I had an X5 before this.
Okay.
I wanted to make that car, one of the best cars on Bangalore street. So I wrapped the car in yellow and got 20 inch rims for the car.
Whoa.
The thing is, I wanted those 20 inch rims to be proper. I went to London. I was in London at that time. So I bought 20 inch rims that time for around 1 lakh for the whole set.
Okay.
And I bought it from all the way from UK to India. Oh. And that was an experience, honestly. Each of the rims were 25 kgs.
Yeah.
So basically, we had carrying capacity of 400 kgs.
Hmm.
And we could take around 400 kgs, which is per person 100 kgs. And we had taken extra allowance because of the wheel only.
Wheels.
So 100 kgs went in this, another 100 kgs went in our luggage.
And all.
We were there for 15 to 20 days.
Okay.
This is around 3 years ago.
Okay.
This is just how much of a car guy I am.
Yeah.
And after I sold the X5 and all, the whole story changed. I had a Range Rover before this also. I had a white color Range Rover before this. And that car was a beast, honestly. It also had a 4.4 liter twin turbo V8. It was the same year car. That was a 2013, but the old shape.
Old shape, yeah.
And then I sold that car and I got this car because I wanted a newer.
How did you feel? Was it an upgrade or did you go into the problems?
I mean, I've kept this car for 3 years, so I would say it's a deal, honestly.
Yeah. So, what do you think are the positives of this car? Like, few positives in points you can tell to the viewers.
Few positives about it's very comfortable. It's very luxurious.
Yeah.
You know when you are at a high speed, the stability is
stability.
Fantastic.
Okay.
Fantastic. The comfort you get on bad roads is just immaculate. The way this car makes you feel when you're going through the streets is just wow.
Yeah, the road presence, especially, you get everyone just turns their head to look at this car. It's just really wonderful.
You can alter the settings of the car. It's an off-road specific car. So
in the center console, you get the controls for the air suspension, right?
So, for example, we go here. And now if I want to go to grass, gravel or snow mode, the car will automatically, you don't decide what to do with the suspension and what to do with the articulation. And depending on what mode you're using it for, it will automatically decide on what to do with the car. Now this is the grass, gravel or snow mode. This is the mud and ruts mode. So the roads that we came from right now, which would be very suitable for this mud and ruts mode. Then there is sand mode. Also, this car is used by many Arabs also.
Okay.
And when they'll be hitting the
dunes,
that time this car is also a fantastic car.
Yeah.
Along after that, there is the mode called rock crawl mode.
Okay.
Rock crawl mode puts the car in a low range mode. It tells the car to go into low range mode because rock crawl mode in this.
It's like the four low.
Four low, yes,
yeah.
Basically. And instead of doing all of that, you can just put it in auto and automatically the things will be done for you.
Okay, it will just sense the roads and change
accordingly. Now, you also have the feature of, going down. This is a traction control.
Okay.
You can go down. As you can see.
Yeah, the ride height of the car is getting down.
And then this is full low. Now, if you step outside and have a look, the car will be absolutely slammed.
Yeah.
You can't, it's not recommended to drive the car in this stance. So, people just usually put it in normal and drive it.
Yeah. So, this was the complete ownership review of Hussein of his Range Rover. Really, this car is a mad-ass car and really thanks to him, he got the car in really short notice. And also, would you recommend this car to someone who is looking for a...
luxury car, obviously. Yeah. This car over a G-Wagon, you know. when you drive a G-Wagon, the car is just... It just goes up.
Yeah.
It just does not have any, you know, grunt and feel to it. This car has something in it. It has a character. It has a diesel motor, that V8 diesel motor that just... Even the G63 cannot give it to
yeah.
you. Maybe, yeah, on power...
This is an unpopular opinion.
Yeah, very unpopular opinion. People are like, go for a G-Wagon.
G-Wagon is nowadays really overrated.
Yeah, many people have it, but, it is something that is, you know, meant for only a driver. People behind are just left to, you know, rot in it. It's just an off-road car. It's not meant to be driven on the streets of Bangalore. It's meant to be driven on a, you know, rough terrain where people can, you know, off-road and, you know, slide around. It's a basic off-road car, basically how you drive a Thar, but 90% of the time it'll be driven on the
roads.
So if you're gonna drive on the roads, just buy a Range Rover instead. You can go in style and in comfort.
Yeah, so if you like this video, please like, share, comment, and also don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon to get notification of all my future videos. And also do follow me and Hussein on Instagram, link will be on the description. Thanks for watching.